Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life.
Town of my childhood, town of my dreams, I'm tied to the place where I once grew. It's got no culture, it's got no arts, but I know those faces, I love those hearts. It's a hick town, sure it is, but I don't mind, because in it I can.
Welcome to Our Town, a local history quiz that has retro revelers battling against Regency ruse with their locals' insider knowledge on everything historical. Historical meaning any time in the history of Brighton and Hove. This week, we invite two guests to join our captains, and obviously our captains with Jax here. How are you, Jax? You well?
Very well, thank you.
Good. And Carol, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks, Andy.
Good. And with Carol this week is Roy Pennington. Hi, Roy, how are you?
Hi, I'm OK.
And what have you bought for us this week, Roy?
I brought in a book called Jimmy Edwards, The Wake Up at the Back There. It's Jimmy Edwards. It's a book about his life and work.
Where did he live?
He lived in Rotting Dean for a couple of years.
A couple of weeks, yeah. On a holiday.
He then moved back to Sussex, to a farm in the middle of Sussex. He worked with the foxhounds in the South Down Hunt.
Right.
And he went to, then carried on working at the BBC.
Right. And with Jax tonight, obviously, we've got, I would call him a guru, really, Chris Horlock, who has written, is it nine books?
Nine books. And I'm exhausted.
Yeah, but you keep producing them.
I know.
What's the latest one?
One on Sussex as well. The latest one is called Lost Brighton.
Lost Brighton, and that's available in all good bookshops.
Well, it's coming out in a week or two, and it's just, I didn't know where to stop, really, you know.
But you'll keep writing books, won't you?
Well, we'll see.
And I mean, for a lot of people who watch this, a lot of people who are on Facebook, Brighton Past, regularly see the James Gray photos of people.
Yep. Yeah, I knew him. I knew him for nearly 20 years.
You're heavily involved in that because you knew him.
Yeah, I did.
And you've bought a couple of bits along, which we will see on screen.
Yeah. Western Road and one of an old laundry in Whippingham Street.
It's fantastic. So this, I think, is the laundry. If you look at the screen, guys, that's the laundry.
That's the laundry. And that's 1911.
Right.
It became four fars just after the war, 47, 48, I think. From directories, I haven't quite pinpointed it yet, but obviously that was a place where many people in the area would work, and I'm sure people looking at it would think, oh, my mother used to work there, or my grandmother, you know. Yeah. It would have employed a lot of people. Then it closed, I suppose, as people got washing machines and things after the war, and, you know, laundries closed a bit, not too much, and then it became Four Fars Bakery, and of course Four Fars have just closed spectacularly. Their demise. I still haven't taken it in, really. Four Fars. Closure.
All of us locals are going, where's Four Fars? I can't go and get my cheap cake. Thank you, Chris. Yeah. It is interesting that the stuff that you know you are a guru, because a lot of people do go to you for your stuff. So, Carol's brought in a couple of books this week, which have got a house that you quite like.
Yeah, I'm a bit fascinated by this house. It's called the Escallop House, and it was near the town hall, up where Bartholomew's is now. It was owned by a man called Jenkins, and they wanted him out, basically, because they wanted to put Bartholomew's Road through it, where his house was, and they tried to get him, offered him money, and he didn't want to know. So one day, someone came along and said, oh, would you like a nice day trip out to London? We'll take you up to London. And he was like, oh, this is great. So off he went to London, and then when he came back, his house had gone. Completely demolished.
Fantastic.
So, but what's amazing is it was completely covered in scallop shells.
Well,
it must have looked amazing.
Unbelievable. And Jax, what do we not know? We've learned something new about you again this week.
Oh, God.
No, the chemical degree.
Oh, right.
You just astound me every week.
I thought you knew that.
I didn't know that. The pilot and the model and everything else. And now you've got a chemistry degree?
Yeah, I studied chemistry at Sussex.
She's local.
When I was a mature student.
Doesn't matter. You've done it. Yeah. So this week we decided to ask some questions on people. So I've tried to make it a bit tough, so there may well be a struggle, but let's look at the first picture. Who and what connection, from a Brightonian's point of view?
Is that Ernest Beale?
Yes, yep. It is.
It is Ernest Beale. Connected to Beale's The Stationers.
Yeah, yeah. Beale's
got,
The Stationers.
Got the VC in World War I.
Correct. Mm. But Beale, if, Roy, do you remember Beale's The Stationers in East Street?
No.
No?
East Street? No, no.
Big Stationers.
Big Stationers,
taken
yeah.
Taken over
yeah.
by... Sussex
Stationers. Yeah.
Breeden's Bookshops. They all went into one.
Yeah. So right. he was, let's say, he was also very heavily involved in the Boys' Brigade as well, I think, yeah. on Lewis Road. And the next one.
That's old Beardsley, isn't it?
It is. Aubrey Beardsley
yeah.
who was a...
Brighton
young boy.
Student. Educated at Basfic.
That's right.
And that's he was, right, yeah.
Was an illustrator, wasn't he?
When did he die? He died, he was less than 30.
Yeah, he was very young when he died.
Yes, he was.
I think he was in his 20s, he was like 28 or something. Yeah. But he went to Basvik and lived with his aunt, I think, in Lansdowne Square.
That's right, he did, yeah. Yep.
And who is this? Ah.
Gracie Field?
No. She's got a plaque. She has got a plaque. I've been in her house, actually. When she died, and later on.
Well, it's not.
That's Elizabeth Allen, the actress.
Yes.
And she lived in Courtney Terrace, had a whole house in Courtney Terrace.
Do you know her, Karen?
No.
No, nor do I.
Well, I have. She was in Tale of Two Cities, The Heart of the Matter. She was a very, very famous.
What, Graham Greene, Heart of the Matter?
I think it was actually, yes. Mm-hmm. So let's try this one, Jack, see if you know this one.
You should know this one, Jack.
Are you asking me?
Yes, we are.
I'm trying to put stuff in there.
Yes, I do. I can't think of her name. Oh, it's Alexandra Bastida.
Correct.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
And
she's a local girl.
Yeah.
Where did she learn her drama? Any idea?
It wasn't in Kemp Town.
No.
That little place there.
No. Think of the nicest door in the town.
Oh, up in Montpelier.
Oh, that one.
Yes.
Montpelier Road.
I did elocution lessons there.
That's right. Well, in fact, for those who don't know, the boards of the winners are still up in the hallway, in the entrance hallway. And Alexandra Bastido's name's on there. I think it's 63 or 64.
Yeah.
She also went to the high school.
That's right.
For an extra point, what was the TV series she was in?
It started with the...
Champions.
Champions, of course it is.
Ironically, it only ran for a year and a half.
Yeah, that's right.
But she was wooed by several... Right, what did he give to the town and what was his main house called?
Oh, that's Booth.
Correct.
Is it?
Yes. I've got one with his hat on. Photo of him with his hat on. That's interesting, yes, because they must have taken several pictures.
Yeah.
Bleak House.
Correct. Bleak House, which is where Fairways is in Dyke Road.
Right next
I thought
to
Bleak House was down in Kent.
No, Bleak. The house,
Margate,
the house that he owned.
Dyke Road.
Oh. Dyke Road, which is next to Booth Museum, was actually originally called
was it?
Bleak House. Who and what is his legacy?
Who?
Oh, that's That is the guy that when Kemp ran out of money.
Oh,
not
yeah.
Kemp. No, when Kemp ran out of money at Kemp Town, Cubitt.
Cubitt. Thomas Cubitt.
Thomas Cubitt.
He finished the estate.
Who basically was the builder of most of Kemp Town.
Yes.
So, you know, that was his legacy. Who is this, and where was he at school?
That's Brunel.
Correct.
It must be Bristol, I thought.
No, Isambard Kingdom Brunel.
Is that?
Yeah. And he, for a short period of time, went... Correct. It's a controversial one. It was called Dr. Morell's boarding school or something.
Yeah.
One for you, possibly, Jax. Who is this? Where did he live?
recognise a face, do you
know? Is it a hairdresser?
No, it's not.
No, he's a restaurant, didn't he?
Give us a clue.
Terence Rattigan.
Oh, Rattigan. Oh, he lived in the corner of a Bedford Street, a very influential.
There's a photo of him, if I may say so.
Couple of his plays.
Oh,
Deep Blue Sea. It's on at Chichester.
With the boy, the
Winslow Boy.
Winslow Boy.
Right. We're coming up to the break now. Who and what would Brighton not have been if it wasn't for him? See you after the break with the answer.
Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life. Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life.
Welcome back to Our Town. Before the break, we asked you, who was this and what was his legacy, and Brighton would not have been without him. And Carol said...
It's Dr. Richard Russell.
And an extra point from anyone who can give me the name of his book.
You were going to say that.
It's the longest title.
Oh, my goodness.
Day, Tabulus.
Well, it could be, but in English, in English, it is a dissertation concerning the use of seawater in the diseases of glands, which basically launched Brighton as a sort of place to go, really.
Well, he was one of several. And I think the only reason we talk about him so much is because he's the only one we've got a photo of, a picture of, you know, all the others.
Where was his house?
Russell House by the Steam, where the Royal Albion is now.
Yeah, right, next photo. Who and where?
Fault. Magnus Fault?
Nope.
Is it up at the dike?
It is up at the dike, yes.
It's the chair, it's the seat that's still there, unveiled in 1928.
And who's that?
Denman?
Correct. John Denman. Yeah.
Who designed it?
Designed it. Mm. And also, what other buildings? Does anyone know what other buildings in the town he designed?
Oh, my goodness.
The aquarium?
No, that's
another one. Denman.
Oh, Denman.
Oh, the Citizens' Advice thing.
Citizens' Regency.
Loads
of pubs.
Loads of Kemp Town pubs. He was the resident Kemp Town architect. The All Bar One, which was the Argus Gazette building in Steam, down by the Steam.
Oh, yes.
But yeah, very famous. Right, I think we might go, just in this instance, I think we might get a bit more modern. Who was this? And anyone can name two or three of the bands that he's been in. Born in Brighton, went to Patcham School.
No idea.
Steve Ferroni, who was the drummer in Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Duran Duran, and the Average White Band.
Wow, there you go.
Right, who's this and what's he famous for designing? This is a tough one. Born in Hove. No. I didn't know this, I had no idea.
No, pass.
Some kind of architect?
An architect, yes.
Oh, well done.
He is Sir Nicholas Grimshaw, who designed the Eden Project in Cornwall.
The which one?
The Eden Project.
Oh, right.
And he was born in Hove. I didn't know that one either. One for Jax. One for Jax.
No, I won't get it.
You will get it. Who is it? What does she start? It's Barbara Hulanicki.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Who started?
Did I see Bieber?
Who and who did she ask for architectural help and where?
Don't know.
No? That's Victoria Sackville West, or Baroness Sackville.
Who is it?
Yes. And who did she ask to help her? Does anyone know that one? Edwin Lutyens. He asked her to redesign his house in Sussex Square, and she lived in White Lodge in Rodine. So, very wealthy. Right, this is one which I would hope somebody will get. Fairly easy, but why did he move to Brighton as a young boy? Got a microphone in his hand, if that's...
Well, he's obviously a broadcaster or something.
Good. Think of...
The races?
No, think of West Street. What was
oh,
that?
Is it to do with the SS Brighton?
Correct.
Right. No, is it Alan Weeks?
It is Alan Weeks.
You'd never know.
Well, you'd never. Well, I try to. You know.
Every photo of him, he's bald. Like
I know. But the great thing that I learned was why he actually physically came to Brighton.
Why?
I'm not sure. Can't...
His father had a job, and he was the pier master.
Of course. Oh. Yes. Yes.
So it's all really quite
Palace Pier.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. I'm
it's
trying.
All connected, isn't it?
I'm trying.
Yeah, you are.
This is difficult, but not too difficult.
It's impossible.
We want to know: would do you think the school, his school, has got a plaque on it? I don't think it has, but who is this?
I can't really see that.
He's
one.
Got. Let's just say his all his clothes are white. If that's
he's a cricketer.
He's a cricketer kid.
Not WC.
No.
Not.
Yeah. Wisdom.
Correct. Oh. That's John Wisdon, who started the book
the
Wisdon.
Books. Yeah, the annual books.
Yeah, the almanac. Yeah, right. Yes.
And he went to school at Middle Street.
Did he?
Yeah. Oh, I just put this in for fun, but who and what connection?
That's Coronation Street, isn't
correct.
It?
Yeah.
I don't know anything about Coronation Street.
It's, who is it? Who is it?
Stan Ogden.
His real name.
That's Bernard Ewins, or Bernard Popley, as he was born in Hove in 1914. And what's quite interesting is you saw him on Coronation Street and he had this massive Mancunian accent.
Yeah.
But he was a proper TV presenter and had a really posh voice.
Oh, did he? Oh, really?
Yeah. And he was born in Hove in 1914. I think he lived in either Livingston Road, up that way. So, yeah. You know. Right, this is one that Chris should know. The next two, I think, is for Chris. Name this... lady, what did she do? What did she do when she retired from what she did?
Right, I think I can do that one.
Go on then.
Because she's connected with where you're going.
Yeah, you're going to
White Hawk. Yeah. Brigden, Zoe Brigden. She was a performing aquatic artiste on the West Pier.
Correct.
So would dive in the West Pier, do fancy diving, and somehow people threw her pennies. I'm not quite sure where the...
Not whether she died in to get them, but...
No, I think there was a little box or something. But when she retired, she became a hairdresser at White Hawk.
Correct.
She?
Mm. Yeah.
Down in the Broadway.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure where her shop was.
Probably,
but,
probably was in the Broadway.
Probably, wasn't it? Yeah.
But that, again, the connection with the East Brighton.
Yeah,
that's interesting. Yeah. Mm.
Who and what did he apparently do first in England and where?
Oh,
that's second.
Well, that's Mohammed.
Mohammed, yes.
And he had the first curry.
Baths.
He brought curry to England.
Yeah, I mean, there's three things he did. And one of them is the first curry house, which wasn't in Brighton, it was in London.
We meant to introduce shampooing.
Shampooing.
Yeah, shampooing,
Britain,
that's
which
what
didn't mean
say,
wash your hair, it meant an all-over vigorous
all-over
massage.
Yes,
all
I know.
Over.
Yes, I know. Naughty.
What else did he do?
He was the first Indian to publish a book in English.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. He opened the first
Ship Street
curry house in the country.
I think it was in London.
In London.
First.
And
yeah,
then
London
he came
first,
down
and
here.
Maybe we were second.
Maybe. I mean, if he was down here, there was obviously people following him. I mean, that completes our round of questions. And obviously, thank you, Roy, for bringing in your
pleasure.
And I hope you enjoyed the experience.
It is, yeah. And I hope that this, the book is interesting for people who find it.
Yeah, well, people can see it on the screen. Is it available? Can you get it in...?
I don't know if any of the shops are
websites,
shopping at it yet.
Websites,
on,
which we can't
on the,
mention.
Online, you can...
Online,
look
that's
it. Up under, under the name, actually.
Under Jimmy Edwards, just typing. Jimmy,
the Anthony Slide, the author, is a well-known cineast, a person who writes books about films and everything.
Okay. And Carol, I presume, as we said earlier, you've got to go home and answer hundreds of people writing and putting stuff on Facebook still.
Well, yeah, it's an ongoing daily thing, yeah.
I just, for both you and Jax, I'm just mindful of what you do today. Jax, what's the date of the draw for the next raffle for the Madeira Terraces?
30th of August, 2019, at the Cricketers Pub, the old... The oldest pub in Brighton.
And you will basically They're on sale.
They're on sale now, £1 each. Get them from me, get them from all over the town.
Go on Facebook, anyone, go on the Terrace Facebook site.
Yes, online.
Everywhere.
They're everywhere.
In fact,
yeah, and we're going to end up with about 1,000 prizes this time. We had over 800 last time. It's going to be 1,000 this time. We've got nearly 300. Well, we've got 300 now, yes. So
fantastic. As ever, I just wonderful. And Chris, obviously, your books are available all, and the shops, a lot of the shops have still got them, they, the big
Smiths
shops.
And, Smiths and Waterstones, you can get them there and get them online, get my old ones.
I was going to say, your old ones. Yes. The old ones for people starting or people just sort of getting
out of print
busy,
now, but
the now and then ones.
They're all brilliant.
They're all brilliant.
But, your new book's out soon, isn't it?
New book's
Lost
out.
Brighton.
Yeah, Lost Brighton.
Any day now, isn't it? Next week.
Next week, yeah.
But
I think people will be amazed at what's in there. I had to cut a whole chapter on pubs. It was too long.
Hold on. You have to another one. I think that's
Lost
Chris
pubs.
Saying...
There's another book then,
Lost
isn't
pubs.
It, obviously?
Lost pubs, yeah.
Lost pubs,
right.
Definitely.
People, thank you very much for coming. And at home, if anybody wants to write to us or email us, or appear even, we're very happy to have guests and to sit with you.
Want our autographs?
Yeah. Please email us at ourtownthelatest.co.uk. Goodbye. Add to my hip town, kicking time in the slip town, feeling at home in this ghost town. There's no spooks in this happy town. Hick, hick, hi, oh yeah.
Our Town, proudly sponsored by Age UK, Brighton and Hove, helping people in our city make the most of later life.